Is the fact that he wore the T-shirt a big deal?
No, I think the big deal is own it. Like, now that the fact you go in there, you know, yeah, my daughter's, nobody cares. Sit back and say, you know what? Yeah, it was a mistake, man. They did it. But at the time, I thought, hey, this is great. He's telling his whole team that, you know what? We're going to have to be more physical, and we're going to go. We were a better team 2 weeks ago. We're going to be a better team today. They never walked out on the field like that, though. They did just the opposite. He tried to pull away from it. Man, you got to own that dude. If you're going to step up and do something like, we know I've done some of the stupid things like that.
No!
But the difference is, I would go out, my team would have my back. We would play our butts off. I never saw that type of energy from his team.
Listen, this is a team in this season of all this promise, in which we've been talking about watches, and we've been talking about cleats, and we've been talking about people hitting each other in the head with a helmet, and now we're talking about the coach's T-shirt. I mean, what the heck is going on here?
Listen, Greeny, you have the T-shirt, whatever, dude. Fourth quarter, you get an interception with 7 minutes to go in the game, and you go throw. Like, Pittsburgh gives you a gift. This is the story of your season. Pittsburgh gives you a gift. You get first down at the 30-yard line. Let's throw the ball. Why would we run the football with Nick Chubb? Oh, here's an incompletion. We have a chance to go get ourselves back. Second down, let's throw the ball again, because I have no stinking clue what I'm doing as a head coach of this football team. Third down, let's throw it again. Sack, get us out of field goal range, and we have to pooch punt it. Like, this maddens me how you can mismanage situations so poorly as a head coach. It's the definition of your season. Take the T-shirt for what you want. Another example that you are just so unqualified of being a head coach, when you get that situation at the 30-yard line and you go throw, when all you can do right now is run the football.
I want to let you
know,
Dan.
He's getting better, though.
I think so.
He's getting better.
Because?
Why? Hey, no 4th-and-9 draw. Like, come on. This guy is, I mean, you talk about going like
hold
this.
Hold on. All right. So let me.
He is doing that.
Dan, it really hurts me to see you distraught. I saw him cry yesterday. I almost cried at home. I mean, this is a real moment we're having to get to this. For those that don't know, whenever you pop out of a birth canal in Pittsburgh and Cleveland, you're taught to hate each other, right? That's just the way it goes. Pittsburgh hates Cleveland.
It should be.
Cleveland hates Pittsburgh.
Sure.
It's an old school rivalry, let alone de-helmeting someone and hitting them with their own helmet. It can only escalated. So the T-shirt, I think, is only adding fuel to the fire, just like old Cuz said. So I think it is a dumb decision. I think he pawned it off on his daughters, which is, by the way, dad of the year type stuff. I really can't blame him there. But I don't have a kid. I'd probably blame my daughters too if I could at any given moment. But I don't have a child, so I can't do that. And I'd probably never be a head
Thank
coach.
God for that.
But he does stink, maybe. Does stink, though. And it shows in not only the lack of discipline off the field at a movie theater when you're wearing a shirt, but on the field, they are still the most penalized team in documented history. But don't let any of that distract you from the fact that Ducky Hodges waddled his way into the MVP conversation yesterday. A 96 passer rating compared to Baker Mayfield, number one pick in the draft, all world, 45 commercials, 72 passer rating. Ducky Hodges is a weapon. He had nobody around him. He was making plays, and Mike Tomlin should be up for coach of the year for what he's been able to do.
May just a final word on the shirt, he wore a shirt that said Pittsburgh started it. Yesterday, Pittsburgh ended it.
Duck!
And that's pretty much it. Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.